Joining us on the line right now for our Redskins report is Trevor Maddich. I want to mention that the Redskins report with Trevor Maddich is brought to you by Fork Union Military Academy. Hello, Trevor.
Well, good morning, guys. Well, anything happened lately?
Yeah, it's a good morning in that we had a victory. I mean, we decimated Jacksonville, but the other side of that is, of course, we had a terrible loss in that RG3 went down with a dislocated ankle, and we also DeSean Jackson is hurt a little bit, and we don't know when he's going to be back. But let's talk about RG3 because that's what everybody's focused on right now. Dislocated ankle, it seems like a pretty serious injury. What's the latest that you're hearing about this?
Well, Brian, the latest I'm hearing is that this kind of injury almost always is accompanied by a fracture. And the rosiest scenario that the speculators are speculating is be out for 2 months, which essentially, even if that's all it is, would put him out pretty much for the season. Because then he'd have to come back and get back into shape. He'd have to get back into chemistry with the receivers. And so I expect RG3 to be out for the season, but we're still waiting for the official word.
All right, so here's what Kirk Cousins, who came in and did an admirable job yesterday, give him his credit, here's what he said about all this.
This is Robert's team. You know, my job is to be the backup quarterback, and if called upon to come in and play, and I better play well and help this team win. So that job doesn't change.
Let me ask you this question. If Kirk Cousins plays well while Robert Griffin III is out for 2 months or maybe the rest of the season, is it still Robert's team?
No. No. You can't lose your job to injury, but you can lose your job to your backup performing better than you. And at some point, the Redskins might have to make a decision that they have to do what's fair to the rest of the team and throw open the quarterback job to pure competition. Because RG3 is the guy they mortgaged the future for. But the rest of the guys on the team are part of the future as well. So it's all speculation. I mean, Kirk Cousins did a great job, but I can't remember seeing recently an NFL defense that had more wide open spaces in the secondary
for a quarterback. I agree with you on that.
Than what Jacksonville gave to Kirk Cousins. So we still don't know what Cousins can do. But if Cousins does well, the Redskins owe it to the rest of the guys to throw that job back open to competition.
So we got to see 4 good minutes of RG3, and he really did move the ball well, including the play that he ended up on the ground. You know, so often in his first season, he didn't actually see the receiver catch the ball because he was on the ground, and the same thing happened here, and then Kirk Cousins comes in and scores the touchdown on his first play. All in all, after seeing RG3's 4 minutes and then Kirk Cousins executing the Jay Gruden offense, can we start to form some judgments about how this offense is looking, or have a huge asterisk next to it because it's the Jacksonville Jaguars defense?
Yeah, that asterisk is important because RG3 looked brilliant early in the game. In the first series, he threw that deep vertical pass in the left seam to DeSean Jackson, and it was a terrific throw. Jackson had it in his hands, but then lost it at the very last instant on the ground, and so that was a good throw by RG3. Even the play where RG3 got hit was a heroic pass by Robert. He was rolling to his right. He jumped in the air to escape a tackler and then landed on that ankle, injured it, popped back up in the air, and while he was in the air with his foot pointing a weird direction, flying out of bounds, he hit Jackson on the pass. He completed the pass.
Jeez.
Then he hit the ground and stayed down.
Yeah.
And so RG3, with his running and with the way his throwing was going early, I think would have had at least the game that Kirk Cousins had against Jacksonville. So, yeah, this game you can't tell anything. RG3 was progressing, but Jacksonville was awful.
What about DeSean? What's the latest on that?
Yeah, Brian, he seems to be day-to-day. He fell to the ground with a defender on top of him, and he has a sprained joint in his shoulder. And the report right now is day-to-day. He may or may not be able to play against Philadelphia. But either way, the Redskins' receivers are incredibly deep. Even without DeSean Jackson, with the addition of Andre Roberts as a free agent, the Redskins are fine there. And Kirk will have a lot of guys to distribute it to. But obviously, whenever Jackson does come back, he'll blow the top off of defenses, and he makes a big difference.
All right, as you look at the entire game in total, you know, we're seeing more and more of the Jay Gruden offense. We're seeing more about how Jay Gruden wants to do football. Do you see anything that jumps out at you as rather interesting or surprising?
Yes. What's interesting to me is how well this offense works when the ball goes to the right place at the right time. This is sort of a West Coast version offense, which means that the quarterback needs to throw the ball before the receiver comes out of his break, before the receiver gets to where he's going. So a quarterback that's accustomed to reading the defense and throwing the ball on anticipation of where the receiver will be is what's important. And Kirk Cousins is ahead of RG3 right now. But we saw the pace of the offense pick up a little bit from what we saw in the opener with Cousins running it. When I say pace, I mean everything seemed a bit more energized. The ball was coming out more quickly. The players seemed to be coming out of the huddle more quickly. It was just happening faster. And it's not because Cousins is more talented, but I think because he's more accustomed to this kind of an offense. And I think you've got to give credit to Cousins in his preparation, because the team was the first team was used to RG3's cadence, his demeanor in the huddle, the way he called everything. And sometimes there's a bit of confusion when the backup has to come in for significant time.
Right.
But Cousins was ready to go. So this offense actually was a bit more crisp under Cousins.
And I don't think we can really talk about yesterday's performance without giving a huge hat tip over to the defense. I mean, the Jaguars couldn't really get anything going with their quarterback on the ground as many times as he was.
Yeah, 10 sacks, and Ryan Kerrigan had 4 of those sacks. It was fantastic. And there were 2 contributing factors to that. Actually, 3. What was it? The offense got a big lead so the defense could take some risks. It's been a while since that's happened. The second thing is that the Jacksonville Jaguars are just awful. I mean, they're just terrible.
Yeah.
You need to savor this, but don't let this define the Redskins. The defining moments will come against better opposition, including next week. And the other thing is Jason Hatcher, signed as a free agent from the Dallas Cowboys, defensive lineman. He has been unblockable in the first 2 games, and even though he only had 1.5 of the Redskins' 10 sacks, he was responsible for far more of them because he kept on moving up and down the line, finding the weak spot,
Yeah. And
drawing double teams so other people could get there in single blocking.
All right. Well, Trevor Maddich, thank you so much. Always appreciate it. I want to remember one more time that the Redskins Report is brought to you by Fork Union Military Academy.